adult audience. Loveline may contain sexually oriented content. Listener discretion is advised.
Loveline with Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew.
Hey, everybody, it's Loveline. I'm Adam, that's Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Dr. Drew, board-certified physician, addiction medicine specialist.
And our guest?
David Alan Greer, who's fast becoming not my main man.
No.
Yeah.
Quite not at all.
He used to be my main man.
Yeah.
But since he's canceled the show like 2 times in a row and... now he's not showing up. But you know how I feel, Drew?
Yeah.
I was looking forward to seeing David. Now he's not here. I hope he doesn't show up. Because I look at everything as work.
Yeah.
Even stuff I want to do as work.
Yeah.
Something gets canceled. Even if a vacation gets canceled.
No, I know.
I'm happy.
For you, breathing is an issue.
Hold on.
Certainly sleeping is.
Don't talk to me while I'm trying to inhale.
In fact, I really think eating and masturbating are the only things you don't consider work.
Now,
even those become work for you sometimes.
Well, especially when I eat my stuff. You know what I mean? That's what I call the circle of life, Drew. I beat off on a Ritz.
Hey, guys.
Yeah.
Hate to interrupt, but David's here.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes.
That's why he gets the big bucks.
He had some kind of bottle in his hand, too. We sent him away.
Good. Okay. You know, let me tell you the beauty of this job. Let me tell you the beauty of the Loveline staff. Here's what happens here at Loveline. Same mistakes happen. If they happen once, they happen 300 or 400 times, right?
He's been here, though.
He has been here.
Yes, he has.
Uh-oh.
Can't blame the staff for this one.
I do. Right. Here's the way the Loveline staff works. The guests show up at the old studio every single time. Every single time, the Loveline staff goes, "Hey, what are you going to do?" I told them. But at a certain point, let's just say this was a job where you could get fired, you would get fired. And that other part where you go like...
But we know, we learned from Lauren that radio cannot get fired.
Right. Hey, I told them... Here's how radio works. They don't pay people in radio, so they can't fire them. Because you can't really fire... Like, if a retarded guy shows up at your house every day and rakes your leaves and washes down your rain gutters and wipes down your car with a chamois...
You can't fire them.
And then he doesn't show up one day, what are you going to do, fire him?
You can only have him taken away.
That's it.
Yeah.
That's all you can do. You can get like a restrainer, but how can you? Why would you fire somebody you weren't really paying?
Yep.
All you do is bring out a cup of Sanka and give him a couple Junior Mints, and he's good for the month. Why? Mm-hmm. Why fire him? So one day he rakes all the leaves into the pool. Still doesn't matter. What are you going to do? You have to hire a gardener.
Ahead. That's right.
You'll have to hire a gardener and a pool man,
mm-hmm.
and that's going to cost money. So this is what radio does. Radio doesn't pay people, but then they can't fire them. So it's a great circle. It's great, yeah. The guests on this show, they show up late half the time. Nothing we can do about it. Except for if it was any other business, you'd be fired. That's how it works. What can you do? Don't pay anybody? Don't get any performance? Fine. It's all right. It's great for everybody.
It's a county facility.
Yeah. It's a county facility. All right, so anyway, DAG... who may still yet be my main man. Although if he showed up at the other studio, he's got to be drunk or high.
Yeah.
Well, he doesn't get drunk or high.
He had a bottle in his hand.
He had a bottle?
Was it cracked?
I don't know what it was. I saw on the black and white monitor. It looked like, he's probably listening right now, but it looked like tequila.
Really?
Is he,
what'd you say? Was it cracked?
Had he cracked the bottle?
Oh, the seal on it.
The seal, yeah.
Yeah,
yeah,
okay.
he was definitely drinking out of the bottle.
That's what I'm talking about.
All right.
He has been here before, yes?
I think he has been in this studio before.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, because remember he was showing us his technique about how he made love to a woman.
Oh, that was here. I would love to hear that again.
That was here, yeah. Anderson will whip that up for us. Amber?
Hello.
You're 23?
Yes, I am.
What's up?
Okay, I was listening to your show recently, and I just want to know if you can clarify an issue for me.
Mm-hmm.
I go to a community college or junior mm-hmm. college.
Junior college. Yes.
So I was just wondering why someone in a position to help people and to give advice would do mm-hmm. would not do as much as possible to encourage education, higher education for everybody.
I'm glad you brought that up. Higher education. The only thing higher about junior college is the amount of weed that's dealt out of the snack shack. That's the higher part of junior college.
Wait. Let's do
I'll tell you what I'm interested in. I'm interested in people being realistic.
Exactly.
Not everybody is a student. God knows I'm not. Most of my friends aren't. It's a huge waste of time. Hey, but I'm not a lot of things.
Right.
I'm not a ballerina. I'm not an opera singer. I'm not an NBA star. And for me to attempt to do that stuff is a waste of my time. And for society to sort of underwrite that effort is a waste of resources. Now, here's the thing. If you're a good student in high school, you'll go off to a real college. If you're not a good student, you should probably go off to work, or better yet, some sort of trade school where you spend a year, you learn how to be a computer tech or a dental technician or an ambulance driver or an EMT, and then you go off and make a decent living.
Here's the one caveat, though.
Nursing school and Asians.
Those are the exceptions, but there is another issue that you really don't take into account.
Yeah.
That the junior college institutions being basically incarceration, prisons for the lesser students.
Yes.
Sort of Midwest and East, they're considered good schools.
Well, that's because people are stupid.
No, and people go there and then almost routinely go off to higher education.
Almost. No.
They do. There's a certain amount of esteem to some of these communities. And you notice they call them community colleges there, too. They don't call them junior colleges.
Well, but just like calling retarded people special.
Amber, am I not right?
It's a euphemism, true.
Amber.
I would hate to agree. No.
Yeah. Look, you disagree.
I will.
Here's the deal. What percentage of people that go to junior colleges transfer into four-year universities? I would argue under 20%. That's alarming.
I was wondering, though, is this from some kind of like a personal experience or lack of experience with community colleges that gives you this kind of resentment towards people generally a little bit older than the other people going into college directly after high school makes you so resentful towards the education they could provide? I mean, education is definitely something people have to take on an individual basis, and I work extra hard at everything I do.
Quiet down. Ellis, if you worked extra hard, you'd be in a real college. Now, let me say this. Education, education, and no one can argue with. It's like saying, hey, for the kids, it's for the kids. It's for education, for the kids. What's wrong? We put a premium on education. Look, people need to, education is a luxury. You need to make money. You need to pay your bills. You need to survive. You need to provide. You need to have a health insurance. You need to do this. You need to pay your tax. You need all that. Education is a luxury. It's a luxury that some people can afford, and it's a luxury that some people earn. But it's not going to be good for a guy who doesn't have any money, who isn't highly motivated, who doesn't feel like going to work, who just wants to hang out for another few years and live at home. It's not getting him anything.
Again, the more macroscopic view of this, though, is that we as a society need to have a more educated workforce so we can compete internationally better.
Amber.
Yes.
What does macroscopic mean?
Macroscopic is the larger scale, the big perspective of the whole deal.
Why aren't you in a four-year university?
It's an economic thing. I'm a homeowner, and my husband and I are both very young, and we just are trying to make our way. And so my option at this time was to go to community college, and it just provided so
much
charisma. And I mean, I've tried a four-year school, and I picked one that was not as...
It was a stripper's name. Listen, what are you studying over there in junior college?
There's an opportunity at my school where you can get your bachelor degree while going to school in your community. And so hopefully by the time I get finished, I'll be...
All right, I'm bored already.
I didn't hear what you were studying.
That's the other thing. Look, listen, everybody. If you want to waste your time in junior college, fine. But here's what everyone needs. Here's what I want all my kiddies to do. When you're 18 and you get out of high school, if you're not going to a four-year university, and a lot of people just go there and waste time too, by the way. I mean, there's universities and then there's universities. A lot of people just go to San Diego State, do jello shots and bong loads for 5 years, and then come back home and work at their dad's sofa factory. I mean, that's nothing but a waste of time either. Uh-oh, here comes what used to be my main man. Dag's got an open bottle.
Oh, there's his tequila bottle.
Oh, he's got a bottle in his hand.
My lipstick brings all the girls to the yard. Their life is better than yours. Their life is better than yours, I teach it. But I'd have to kill them.
What the hell is that?
It's the newest.
How you guys doing?
What's happening?
Well, I'm happy to be here.
Yeah.
That's good.
What happened, Dag? Where were you?
I got stopped. I was signing autographs and...
really?
Yeah, I went to the wrong studio. You guys know because I heard you on the thing.
Yeah. All right, we're hip. But haven't you been to this studio before?
Yeah. I don't remember coming here to do Loveline, but
let me think. There was one memorable scene that occurred here.
Yeah.
Here it is.
Don't look at me. Don't look at me. I will give you something to smile about.
I know it well.
That's how you make love, right?
You know, yeah, it is. And when they're lucky, several times a night.
What?
Yo, you wait. You wait. Yo, you wait. You wait.
Don't look at me. Don't look at me. All over again. Get off of me.
How are you guys doing?
We're doing good, Dag. Yeah.
Beauty.
I ran into Jimmy's brother. He's doing Life with Bonnie this week. What's
Sean Kimmel?
What?
Sean Kimmel?
John. He's doing Life with Bonnie?
Don't sound so shocked, yes.
What's he doing?
He's not an actor.
A very special part. We're doing a telethon episode, so he's the he's Xavier, the sound guy.
Oh really?
The song that he wrote, you know, and he does a really...
But I love that show, by the way.
Thank you.
We've become huge fans.
Well, it's all because of me.
I know.
Basically.
Yeah, we've discussed the fact that they've stepped up your role quite considerably this season.
Yes, they have. I lived with Bonnie. I live with Bonnie and her husband now and the kids.
Mm-hmm. All part of the big ABC TGI Friday
it's
lineup.
True.
Big fan of that lineup myself, Friday nights.
Well, you know, you're always at home watching.
I am.
Now he is.
I am at home. No, I was always home. Seeing, watching Full House and Step by Step and all that crap with Patrick Duffy in it.
And crying.
And crying.
Dude, what happened to your house, man? The one, you know.
I'm working on it.
You haven't been up there?
What kind of friend are you?
Come by tomorrow.
No, man. Yeah. It's Christmas party time, brother.
It's cool.
Christmas party time.
Come by during the day.
I'm chug-a-lugging eggnog.
Not and, doing
know,
anything during the day.
Talking smack.
Hey, Doug.
I'd like to hang some Christmas ornaments on you, baby.
Doug?
Yeah.
You're 23?
That's right.
What's up?
Adam, you badass, David Allen Greer, Batman Majama, Drew.
What's up, man?
Exquisite Passion. Adam, I was just wondering, Love Crank Anchors.
Oh,
you
great.
Your experience been on Loveline and the talent you and Drew seeing the master and reading into people's voices and whatever. You think that helps you when you make prank calls?
Yeah. I don't know. I just try to be funny for 3 minutes and record
it. It's too bright in here, man. What's
Bertram
up?
Rules, man.
The spotlight.
Oh, I'm glad you like Bertram. You know, we did, Dag was over there doing Lynn Danley's Trufeld.
Lynn Danley's Trufeld. I had a wonderful day, man. I had a wonderful, wonderful day.
Give everyone just a little taste of the
how you
truth.
Know, my name is Lynn Danley's Trufeld. You probably don't know me, but I'm a semi-pro ball player. I've recently retired in the last 10 years, and I'm just trying to get my thing back together.
Something like that. Yeah, man, I had a great day last time we were there.
Doug?
Yeah.
Oh, let me say this, too, by the way, Dag. Remember
what's up?
The time before the last time we were in Vegas?
The time, that would be the time,
Mm-hmm.
I was there.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, you were.
And
there.
I made you
Thank
see,
you so much.
Who did I make you see?
You're going to make me get emotional here.
Siegfried and Roy.
You did.
I made you see Siegfried and
you
Roy.
You did.
And he was bitching and moaning the entire time. Like
that was the gayest
pick.
Show. I spent half a... I spent like $1,000 in the Cheetah Club later that night trying to wash the gay off me.
And I said, no, you got to see Siegfried and Roy because if something happens, you're going to want to say
right.
you did it.
Now I'm going to say this. Adam's probably not going to remember, but I swear he was clutching four vodka gimlets or whatever he drinks there because, you know, you got to order in bulk.
Right.
And he said, you know, God forbid one of these crazy tigers rips the larynx out of one of these Nazis.
He said exactly that?
And,
the larynx?
Yeah.
I put the curse on.
Where would you be? You know, this would be the last night in history that,
right.
you know.
So, yeah.
And I said, get out of here. That'll never happen.
Right.
And
don't question
the kibosh on Roy.
You know, these injuries that celebrities are getting are so poorly represented in the press. Like, Ozzy's thing right now is bad.
It's really bad.
I mean,
I heard he broke his neck. Did he break his neck? Eight ribs?
He broke a vertebra. He didn't hit his spinal cord, but he has been on a ventilator since the accident.
Well, eight ribs.
Well,
dude.
And there was bleeding into the pleural space and a crush on the lung. And this is going to be, he's not going to be the same.
Can we talk about this?
He better hope he's not the same.
I was about to say.
It'd be like a Chinese
might not his condition previous to this accident have?
Yes, his Parkinson's. People with Parkinson's disease do not respond well to lung problems.
No, but I'm saying eight ribs.
Oh, he's osteoporosis. I'm sure he has osteoporosis.
I have a friend of a friend, let's say, who's not that old, and she tripped over like one step and crushed her ankle,
like powder. What? You have a eating disorder or something like that?
I mean, it's too much. I mean, it's like they had to put pins in it and all that kind of stuff.
Right. And, but be that as it may,
But the point is,
of course,
I was
did
not
you look at her?
Feel good. Well, you know.
They went through to his lung, and lung is now badly damaged, and it's encased in blood, and it's going to be bad. He's been on a ventilator for a week.
Yep.
How bad? When you get on a ventilator, that's bad.
You can't breathe, bro.
That is bad. And now they're saying that he was actually dead. He had no pulse, no breathing when they found him.
Well, let me...
I actually don't believe that piece of the story. But
well, he's been dead for the last 20 years.
Thank you.
That's my time.
Let me say this.
Enjoy your head in there.
First off, maybe ATV, not his best form of transportation.
A Parkinson's patient should not be on a...
Was not the Parkinson's induced by the drugs that were given to him by the medical community?
Made worse.
How dare you?
They were made worse. Yeah, and anyway, the Parkinson's was not actively addressed with all those medicines.
Ozzy needs to be drying one of those larks with the basket on it that they give you at the Gelson's.
Yes, he needs to have the ones with the tennis balls in the front where you push it.
I mean, this is really sad. I mean,
it is. But let me really say this. Okay, so let's just talk about this for a second, because between Roy and True, please.
And Royce and Luther Vandross. I mean,
Luther Vandross.
He's gone, basically.
Okay, let me say this.
Is he on...
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, my God. A little bit of Cabernet. It's Cabernet and nice fruity blue cheese, gentlemen.
Oh, my God.
A chicken wing or two.
Oh, my God.
Come on, dang.
That was not cool.
I love you.
No,
listen.
All right, now let's talk.
I need to address some things. Now, first of all, I've got a bone to pick with you.
No, wait a minute.
While I'm here, these are the rules. I don't want you giving too much energy or time to these fake calls.
Ooh.
You root them out and move on. Okay?
Right.
If you think it's fake, you punch them off. You don't need to do a 20-minute dissertation.
All right. Fair enough.
Okay? Please. And I need you to go back to the edgy Adam. If you're both Dr. Drew, there's no interplay. Okay?
Right.
If you're both there going... who slept with you? Okay, we need to get you into some help.
The edgy Adam.
Thank you. Don't worry. Good cop, bad cop.
All right.
Don't worry.
I'm going to be in.
Let's heal some babies.
No way.
First caller, go. Nikki, who boned you, honey? Who's been diddling you?
All right, now hold on. I want to talk about these celebrity injuries.
Yeah, yeah.
I want to figure these things out.
Yeah.
I want to know. First off.
Apparently, I have.
I work for, you know, I'm
no,
I blew a fart.
I would never. It's radio. You can't prove it.
Dang. What
this
is up?
Bad.
Oh,
can I light
man.
A match? Can I light
you
a
can
match?
You.
It's getting hot in here.
Oh, holy Jesus.
All right, let's go to the phone. So we'll talk about celebrity injuries.
Did you ask your... Hold on. David.
David?
Yeah, what's up, man?
Have you ever thought about or heard anything about possibly reuniting the In Living Color cast?
You did Doug,
yeah. Yeah, I mean, I just was hanging out with some of those guys tonight.
I guess. Too big, you think?
You were?
Yeah.
Yeah, not Tommy Davidson, though. You guys don't let him hang with you, do you?
Well, apparently he was not in attendance.
Well, Bruce Almighty sucks, so Jim Carrey will probably be down with it.
Bruce Almighty.
I heard
sucked.
That was good.
Yeah, but that was one out of many wonderful films he's done. I'm going to probably be working with Jim soon.
You will?
Yeah.
All right, Doug, we're
double
tired
top
of you.
Secret.
Really? Jim must be manic depressive.
No, why? Because he's a genius? Because he's more talented than you?
Well, you're manic
Because he is more handsome than you? He's obviously manic depressive.
What
why do you say
what
that?
Do you,
It seems hypomanic
think,
all the time.
But you think, you probably think I'm male.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Oh yeah,
no, yeah.
Well, that goes without saying. I
mean, no, yeah. That's not true.
We've talked many times about this.
Well, Adam and I have seen it issues.
Adam, you didn't play those, well, what I call the Daniels phone calls when I'm like, yeah, don't call me back. It's all black outside, please. I can't breathe. There's an elephant sitting on my chest. Adam, please. I'm drowning. Please call me. Please call me.
He calls up, and I'm like, hello, Adam.
Like, David, what? I thought you were feeling low. I'm not feeling fine, no.
Now, who's crazy? I'm even keel. Really? Is Jim Carrey a little bit crazy?
Jim Carrey's wonderful, man.
Really?
Yeah, that's not the point. Yes, he is wonderful.
What?
Mm-hmm.
Well, what is normal, mister? You're crazy, too. You're crazy to heal people. And that's a disease.
All right. Let's heal some babies.
All right. Let's fix some babies.
Mandy.
Mandy, what's up? What's up, baby? What's going on? What's crack-a-lacking down there?
Hello.
Talk to me, girl.
Hi, Mandy.
Hey, Mandy.
Oh, it's Mandy.
Mandy.
I beg your pardon. It's Mandy to me.
Whatever.
Mm-hmm. What's up?
Okay. I think I have a problem, like, having orgasms, like, by myself.
By yourself.
Have you ever had them by yourself?
No.
All right, you're 15.
Yeah.
The women don't often have them until they're close to 20. The biology just isn't syncing up for that yet.
Yeah, well, that's why I don't date the young ones.
But I get them when I'm, like, with guys and stuff.
Just through intercourse?
Yeah.
Do you have more than one?
Right now, or...
When you're not right this second, when you're with a guy.
Hold on. What's going on with this country? We got to start carpet bombing. She's calling from Arkansas.
It's a beautiful thing. She doesn't sound southern either.
Right now?
Well, I'm from Anaheim.
Oh, what are you doing in Arkansas?
I have no idea.
Do you have multiple orgasms when you're having intercourse?
One time, I think I did.
Okay, what are you doing having intercourse at 15?
Well, she's in Arkansas.
I was doing it at 15.
Consider an old maid.
Yeah.
It's kind of common, I think. I think it's normal.
All right, I'm tired of Manny. She's too slow.
Well, wait a minute. When were you having sex, Adam?
16.
15.
15.
15 myself. 15.
Oh. Who's that? Outside
Blaine,
the family?
Blaine Bouvier.
Ooh, sounds
back
hot.
Back my best friend's car.
Sounds hot. Really? How old was she?
It's 15.
15?
You know,
yeah. Work.
We had lovely, loving relations.
What did it sound like? What would it sound like?
This is the first time out.
What would it sound like?
First time out.
I didn't have my bones. I didn't know what I was like. It said it's coming. I'm going. My God.
But David, what did it sound like? By the time you get to the 500th time you had sex,
when I had flex mode, I had a little flex. Flavor going.
Yeah. You know what you want. You know what you look at me. Don't turn. Yeah. I'm gonna fuck.
Dang, honey.
Dang, you're on me.
You're the boss of me.
Oh, jeez.
Honey, you said we were going to go out and eat. You said we were going to eat when we were done.
Shut up.
You said we're going out to Red
Lobster. Get your hands off me.
You said we're going to Red Lobster. You said you'd take me to Red Lobster for the Neptune Planet. I gotta get ready. My dad's gonna come home soon. I'm only 14.
And scene.
All right. The great David Allen here tonight.
Come on, didn't we have a great day? The last day I recorded
my
Christmas
did.
Carols. I can't wait. I was very excited.
Yeah, David did some stellar work in the Crank Yanker studio last time he was in. David Allen Greer Night, Life with Bonnie, 9:30 on ABC Friday night. We'll take a quick break. We'll be right back. Hey, everybody. It's Loveline. I'm Adam. That's Dr. Drew. Dr. Chu over there. David Allen Greer.
Let's heal some babies.
My main man. You can find him on Life with Bonnie, ABC, 9:30, Friday night, tomorrow night, and also making frequent appearances on Crank Yankers.
Let me ask you something, man. Would you like to ask me what I'm here to pump?
Axe?
Yeah, what are you here to pump?
Life.
Life with Bonnie?
No, just life in general, man.
Really?
Ask me where I'm playing, where I'm preparing this weekend.
Where are you preparing this weekend?
In my house. Just, you know, happy with life, you know.
Really?
Absolutely.
Do you, how do you keep grounded, a guy like yourself? I mean,
usually
with all
I like to come around to the radio station and heal some babies. No, I'm here. Now, Dr. Drew, I hear there's Drew 2 is coming.
What's that?
Volume 2 of your healing books.
Yeah, what about your books, Drew?
You haven't read my first one.
I have too. I
read it. That's right. I beg your pardon. Yes, you
man.
Did. I beg your pardon.
Oh,
I forgot.
Man.
What
I read.
I'm so
I
used to my
you
friend. You did. Yes.
A God heartfelt
bless you.
Email.
Yes, you did. I'm so used to my friends not reading my books.
But I will tell you, there's one chick in there who was all tweaked out. I don't think she made it. She was a crankhead. Gee, I wish I could have boned her, man.
What would that have sounded like?
Stop it! Come on! Stop it! Stop it! Oh, that's the old coyote sound.
I went
know.
And
a lot of our porn actresses
discussed a follow up where I have a fantasy where I read a book about the families of those patients come after me and their suits and this and that.
Really?
And
but you changed their names, right?
No, they are no. They're it's all fantasy. It's all sort of based on reality kind of thing.
Oh,
and then create another set of stories that you know.
Well, that's crazy. That'll never go.
I know.
All right, let's
see. They told me. So I am in discussion about another book.
You're like going, but we're on a spaceship, and they're all aliens, and they're the crazy ones, though, not me. And I wind up. It's kind of like Gothica.
You can get into the family dynamic stuff. The family.
Oh, I'd love to.
All right, let me break up the party here for a second and just see.
Book is called Cracked, by the way. Please read.
I want to find out what's going on with Ozzy Osbourne.
Oh, yeah.
What now, Drew, what do you know and how do you know it?
I have gotten used to reading through the lines in the press because they never tell you the
actual
reality.
And what is that about?
It's like Johnny Cash dying of, what was it, pneumonia-related?
Well, he had another disease, right?
Yeah, alcoholism.
Well, that made his head look all swollen up?
Yeah.
And frankly, I'm going on the record here. I don't want to hear Johnny Cash singing Elvis Costello songs and U2. I don't want to hear it.
Me neither.
Now, you take that CD and you destroy it, especially in the last days of his life. I don't want to hear that garbage.
All right, so let me ask you about Ozzy and about Roy. And
Roy had a stroke. He's had a brain injury.
Roy who?
I mean, Siegfried.
And when they say brain injury, I mean, people think, oh, wait, I'd say he'll recover. No, you're talking about irreversible brain damage.
Well, let me ask you
but
this.
What came first?
Why can't we get the full news, the full dump?
I don't know.
The,
I can't understand
I don't understand.
The John Ritter story was sort of half not properly interpreted.
What was wrong with John Ritter's thing?
One of two things happened. And I don't want to disparage. I don't know what happened. I want to disparage the people that took care of him. But do you notice how... When somebody has a heart attack and needs heart surgery, you see the hospital doctor come out and go, here's what happened. We opened his chest. We went in the heart. There was silence. So something happened.
Well, I know what happened. I'm just going to go on. I don't know it all. He's an actor.
Yeah.
Maybe he knew he had a condition, you know, insurance reasons. He didn't want to divulge it.
No. He went in and they began with nausea and vomiting, and they very quickly started looking at his heart. And it sounded as though, in an almost heroic way, got him into the cath lab. Maybe they caused the dissection in the cath lab.
By trying to feed the catheter?
Yeah, that's one of the possibilities. Or they delayed a few minutes, or not, you know, there's some question about the delay in time and what happened in the operating room. You know, what happened?
John Ritter's in the ground.
Yeah.
Love the man, but let's talk about the two guys that are alive.
All right.
Our audience loves Siegfried.
Hey, okay. You know what? I'm not here to talk about this, some Nazi leopard trainer. I'm here to heal some babies. Tracy, line one.
Now listen to me.
Ozzy, sorry.
Dino! Ozzy. Dino!
Here's what I've read in the press.
What happened, Ozzy?
Multiple rib fractures.
Right.
Eight.
Bleeding. Now, what does that mean, multiple rib fractures?
That means
eight ribs.
That all along one side of his chest, it's crushed.
Have you ever broken a rib?
He may have something called a flail chest, where it doesn't even work.
Tell him.
He can't.
Right,
right.
Now, why would
two
all this
fractured rib? It doesn't matter. Two fractured ribs to breathe. It's like every time you breathe, it hurts.
Yes, but if you had two fractured ribs, they'd let you just do it. You'd deal with it.
Eight.
but 8 maybe with flail, and but with also bleeding in the chest cavity, they said, which means blood between the chest wall and the lung,
so,
which encases the lung and becomes scarred and restricts the lung.
Right.
They also said bleeding into the lung tissue, something Kelly mentioned, which can cause destruction of the lung tissue. And then days and days on a breathing machine is extremely risky. You almost always ends up with pneumonia, severe pneumonia.
You get pneumonia.
It's severe pneumonia. And you get dependent on it. And he now the story is about him having had no pulse and not having been breathing for a while. So who knows what
to replace.
Else. I mean, it's a
well, let me ask you this. And if I'm just saying, I'm not saying that he was, but I'm saying if I'm fanning my
yes,
belt,
I see that. Thank you. Thank
over.
You.
The hell
I'm saying that.
Yeah.
I'm saying
that's
that.
Vomit. That's
well, that's the I just ate a Snicker bar.
Yeah.
Top it off. But I'm saying that if he were addicted to any medication, don't they have to wean him off of it? And then,
but now he's going to need opiates. He's going to need pain medicine. They're going to
string
him.
What kind of ATV was he driving?
They're going to have to string him out of stuff.
Thing,
and,
I need to take it
and he's got Parkinson's, and Parkinson's patients don't move well, don't breathe well. They have all kinds of complications from surgeries and illnesses. So it's going to be really, really rough for him.
He's only 55.
Bad road.
All right, let's save some babies.
All right, let's save some babies.
How old is he?
What about like 55? What, 65?
Okay. I don't know.
No. He's 55. That's fair. Yeah. I would believe it. I mean, but given the lifestyle,
what about
what are you thinking? Talk to me.
Well, what do you think? He's 90?
No,
he's 55.
Right. It's I listened to him when I was 15 years old. Dr. Drew.
How old was he? How old do you think he was then?
If he was 25,
all right.
Yeah,
okay.
25. Yeah,
that's the way he is. But I'm saying that means for 30 years he's been living this lifestyle.
Oh, yeah.
That's a long time.
Oh, absolutely. Listen, the part it's hard to get. It takes a long time to get Parkinson's amphetamines.
All right. And Siegfried, what do you think he's doing?
He had it sounds like, again, it's not being spent.
I'm cutting you off for a second because I just want to know. It's not like the guy was injured when a mop handle was broken off in his rectum.
Right, exactly.
During a Easter parade.
You know,
he was injured when he was attacked by wild animals. So why don't you just tell us what happened to him? Shame in it.
It is again the news and the media thinking. Well, the public they're not interested. They can't handle it. They talk down to the public. They don't give them the specifics. People are very.
He's feeling better. He's talking.
He has a vertebral artery injury that supplies the back part of the brain, and that went out.
Mm-hmm.
And that,
how did that occur?
The lion's tooth got it.
But this is what I'm saying. If I made a concerted effort to bite out your, oops, never in all the history I've
Jesus
never
Christ,
missed
Zach.
No,
that's hypomania.
Wow. To bite out your larynx.
Yes,
wouldn't that cause a stroke?
No, it has to hit the arteries.
But you're saying that the tiger caused a stroke, right?
Yeah, seems like.
Yeah, right, you lose blood pressure to this area in the brain
dies.
That quickly?
Oh,
like
few
how
minutes,
quickly?
A few minutes, yeah.
A few minutes. So, I mean, so you got to get that blood back up in there or it dries
now,
out.
Now, there are collateral flows, but, you know, because of peculiarities.
Oh, you're driving
anatomy.
Me nuts. I'm wasting time. All right. There are kids dying out here.
All right.
And it's not tigers that are killing them.
Yes, you're right.
What's in his
bear.
Bottle?
Water. Fiji water.
Sure?
Yeah,
C-U-R.
I'm smelling everything else coming out of him, but not alcohol.
Oh, stop it!
I would be able to tell.
I'll tell you. Shut up! Hey, this is crazy. I'm yelling at myself. Come
hey,
on,
Matt.
Yeah, Adam.
Matt, yeah, you're going to be the one call we take this hour.
I want to do a
buddy.
Show with a virtual Adam
great,
and a virtual
great.
Dave. That'd be great.
Let's see.
Come on,
if we
let's
can
focus
do
in. Let's focus.
No,
in.
Let's
on.
Try that. That's a good let's idea. Let's try Anderson. Let's,
no,
let's
no, see. Just come on. I come here to help these chick kids.
Up.
Come
what
on.
You know?
Matt, what's going on?
Help these chick kids?
So,
what's going on?
About a year ago, I was having sex with my girlfriend.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm uncircumcised, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
Got a nice big chunk of foreskin.
Congratulations.
All right.
And there's a little septum, I guess, where the foreskin attaches to the bottom of the head.
Yes, yes, yes.
It's like a little thin piece of skin.
Yeah,
yes, yeah, we got it.
Oh, gosh.
And that ripped.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And
maybe the guy's anus was too tight.
Hey, bingo. Adam's going to be here at Dingleberry's through Sunday.
I will not be mocked.
Hey, David, you went to Yale?
I certainly did, sir.
It's impressive. I'm impressed.
Beautiful. Now let's get back
it's
to your scrotal.
It's an affirmative action thing. He got a 755.
How dare you?
On his SATs.
How dare you?
They needed one
my SATs were published in People magazine, dude.
Really?
Yeah.
What'd you get?
My results. I don't like to brag. I'm all right. I did all right.
What'd you
do? I think Drew's one of the most sane, rational voices on the radio or in the media.
He's supposed to. That's his job. This guy doesn't have a problem. Go to the next caller.
All right. What is your problem? You tore your frenulum
there? Pews.
Yeah, I tore that, and I didn't seek medical attention because I thought the cut was too small to like cause any significant long-term damage.
There's nothing medical attention really could have done anyway. So.
Right.
Oh, great. See, I was really, but it left like this little white scar.
Yes, that's right. It's called a scar.
I was thinking that, long-term, would I have any erectile dysfunction?
No.
Yeah, you'll have some rectal dysfunction.
Adam! How's it going? Yeah, coming down to the Bray Improv all week.
No, I'm not performing.
No, you're not. No. Here's the thing.
Sir?
He's got that life with Bonnie now, and he's big time. He's living with Bonnie. Dana?
I am.
Yes.
You're 20?
Dana.
Yes, I am 20.
You're shutting me out. I want to see this screen. Dana, how are you?
She's 20.
I'm good. How are you?
I'm from Minnesota.
What's going on? What's crack-a-lackin', mama?
I was just wondering how much pot is too much pot.
How much
like
do
you
smoke?
Well, it's actually not me. It's my brother. I live with him. He smokes sometimes in the morning before he goes to work. And he usually smokes at night, and then sometimes he'll come home on his breaks.
Is this Dana or Dana?
Dana.
Okay, Dana. He is marijuana addicted. He will not be able to stop.
No, he only smokes before he goes to work and then during
his
lunch.
It's a psychological addiction, Dr. Drew.
There is no psychological addiction to pot. It is a physical addiction. And
really?
It is one of the more common addictions we treat now. Represents about 20%. Of admissions to
physically addicted because I keep on hearing that it's just psychological and you can't
Dana,
really get addicted to
Dana,
it.
20% of the patients I admit have marijuana addiction.
So refreshing.
And he can either stop. Here's a very simple test in addiction. You can either stop and stay stopped, or you cannot. And if you cannot, we know a ton about the biology that's operating that makes it so that.
But
you
how
cannot.
Long? It's at least 15 minutes. You have to stop. 15 to 20 minutes.
He has to stop for a year.
Oh, a year, please. How old is this guy?
He's 24.
24. What are you worried about your brother for? Are you worried about yourself?
I live with him, and I love him. He's my brother, so I'm looking out for him.
The other thing, Dana,
if he's token out before he goes to work, he's got a problem.
The other thing is that
I did that for a while.
These guys, we'll talk afterwards. These guys that smoke regularly, when they stop, will also have severe depressions.
Yeah,
and they
I know a friend who's quit, and I talked to her, and she looked like she was going to kill herself.
Well, there's a high incidence of suicide in that period, so they should be watched during that interval.
I told her, I said, I want to watch you, but she didn't take to my account.
But then you wouldn't let her look at you.
You know what I'm saying?
You ever sleep with her?
No, I didn't.
No,
I
didn't.
I don't date the potheads. That's a long night.
If you did sleep with her, probably.
Oh, stop
sounded,
it.
What would it sound like?
No, I'm not going to tap into that. Now, come on.
All right.
Is that
talking about something else over there.
Hey,
Drew.
Listen, I had a friend of mine who had these flaps on her Twinkie, and she got them cut off. I begged her not to do it.
That's really?
She said, she said it was unattractive.
Probably
I said,
this guy.
No, a woman. This is a woman. No. And I said, has any man ever stopped you and said, I can't sleep with you? Those flaps are driving me crazy.
Right.
Of course not.
No.
No, her and her girlfriends... are you going, that's ugly, get them cut off.
It's the same thing with the penis.
She had a labia reduction.
Yeah, and I said, that's a fetish.
She didn't throw out the extra labia, did she?
I tried to scoop them.
You tried to scoop, you didn't get none.
No, I begged her not to do that, but she did it anyway.
Clitoroplasty.
All right, Drew, don't start talking about a book that no one knows David's
looking
at.
I want to find a woman with an enlarged clitoris.
Twinkie hole, baby. Woo!
I like it, baby.
I'm taking a break.
The baby box. What's going on?
Drew, put the book down.
No, you don't. Oh, my gosh.
We'll take a quick break. We'll be right back.
Listen, I want to see the screen. Rule number two.
You got to
get me involved.
Yeah, you need to be more involved in the show. Yeah.
Stop it. You know, I get letters.
You
I have a website.
All
right, let's go to...
I like that Life with Bonnie show, though. I really, really
do.
Yeah, I really do.
I do, too. Yes, yeah. Bonnie's one of my very good friends. People don't believe that.
She seems so bitchy.
No, she's really super nice.
Not.
I almost don't trust how nice she seems.
Nah,
really?
I've heard horrible
you don't trust her? Oh, you didn't. Where did you hear horrible things?
I don't know. She was going to do Kimmel.
I don't know. But she was on Kimmel. I was on there with her.
Oh, she
loves Jimmy Kimmel. She hired his brother.
Thinks her crap doesn't stink.
She hired his no-count brother, and nobody'd hire him but Jimmy. Now, we hired him.
All right.
Come on.
She seems really talented, really nice.
She is. She's wonderful. Right.
And she really? And she gives her friend the big role, yeah.
Well, that was demanded. I had Al Sharpton in there the whole time.
Of course. Yeah, you play that.
We will burn this studio down. Why can't David live in your house?
What do you think about Al? You think, what if he is the president? How's it going to work?
No, he won't. He won't. I got two words. Tawana Brawley, please.
What?
You know what? Listen, Al Sharpton, I'm speaking for all black people in the world. We can do better than that, please.
Seems like you
He's
could.
A squeaky wheel, though. This is America, man. He went from lying about Tawana Brawley, that whole hoax of a case. Now he's a serious politician. Who does he think he is, Bush?
Yeah, I don't know. The Tawana Brawley case is out of New York where the woman claimed that she was abused by, I don't know, white police officers
and
they're all sort of like self-inflicted wounds, and it turned out that she just did this to herself, and I don't think Sharpton ever really issued an apology.
No, but he knew. They knew all the time.
Oh, you think he knew all the time?
Oh, it's a fact. It's a fact. Right. I went to a benefit the other night. Hillary Clinton spoke. I hate Hillary Clinton.
Yeah,
I cannot
too.
Abide her.
She doesn't seem like a human being to me.
No, she'll never be president.
She just seems like sort of a soulless being, like a soulless android who has the intelligence like a robot would, but none of I just think she's completely full of crap. Everything comes
out. Well, I mean, she may be smart and all that stuff, but all I know is, like, after hearing her yap for an hour, I immediately stuck my big boy in a fat girl's bingo.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
What did that sound like?
I just went, That's the best I could come up with.
That sounds like a fat girl.
No, I can't.
I mean,
can't
verbally, when you guys make love.
Shut up.
What would it sound like?
Just for the genitals.
Sound the genitals.
Come here. Come here. Yeah. Come here. You don't look at me. Don't you.
never ever in all my years.
You can't use the F word.
I never said that.
Oh, okay.
There's an 8-second delay, right? Didn't you guys?
No, that went out.
That's the third time now, Dad.
No, it's not. It's the second time, you liars.
You said it during one of the other
shows.
Yeah,
experiences
you heard that. You heard
with
that
woman. Yeah, well, you open each little session with.
I can't.
Don't
do
look
anymore.
At me. You effing.
Don't look at. Don't. Look. Let's go to where are the names. Clara, line 4. Am I talking too loud?
Dave, let's.
What?
Seriously, without the F word, what would it sound like? What would it be like?
Man, you see, that's my week.
You're with
you have
big
it
woman.
On tape.
You're with a
no,
big
I will
woman,
not be cajoled.
And you're coming up from behind her, and she wants to look at you.
Well, first of all, there's a prequel.
Oh, boy. Here we go.
No, come on, let's go.
Right.
Line 4, Clara. No, I'm not going to be. You know, I'm here to say baby.
No,
Clara.
You're not here to.
Clara, you know what? I read Dr. Drew's book, cover to cover.
I know.
Clara, what's going on, Bray?
And they said a very nice email. Congratulations.
All right, quiet down.
What's going on?
Hello?
Yeah, Clara, what's going on?
I just want to say it's really an honor to be talking to you guys. I had two questions tonight. Mm-hmm. The first one was. Last week, I went to a school-sponsored party and got pretty drunk, and one of the professors was there, and he was pretty drunk, too, and he ended up driving me home, and we had sex.
Really?
Yeah.
What is she, 19, Dag?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she's 19.
Now, how old was this professor?
I don't know how. He's in his late 30s or early 40s.
He's not like an assistant or a graduate student. He's actually a full professor there.
Yeah.
You need to report this guy.
Really?
It's completely inappropriate.
Yeah, she said.
That's why there are rules about this.
The problem is, go ahead, baby. Make your point.
He's not my teacher anymore. He used to be my teacher, and back then I really liked him too. And I really have feelings for him. And
I'm sure you do.
Let her talk.
Yeah, but Claire's got boundary problems.
Well, the boundary problems you have is you keep flapping your lips and you don't let the girl talk. Go ahead, Claire.
Boy.
Go ahead.
Mm. Well, I don't want to report it because I really have feelings for him. I really like him, and I actually want it to happen.
Right. And now, does he have any feelings for you?
I don't know. It's kind of awkward because we were drunk, but
it's bogus to me. All of a sudden, it just goes bogus.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's not. I mean, what's bogus? Wouldn't this be a better...
Yeah?
Go ahead, Clara. We believe you, too.
Go ahead. All right, listen. Let me ask you this.
I think he does have feeling for me, too, because there's, you know...
Yeah. Starting to sound like bad acting going on.
All right, listen.
Here.
Are we going to the next call? Are we going to talk to this woman?
No, we're going to take a break. We're going to regroup.
Clara, I believe you, honey. Yep. And if the stink ball puts his member in you again, you say no means no.
Wait, I just have a second question.
Yeah.
What happens if you put a mason jar in your vagina?
See, guys. Okay, little props for this, can I?
Claire, you're a horrible actress.
I know. Well, it was when she had me at first, and she was like, I kind of,
No, because when I started going down the path that would normally resonate with someone who'd been through this, she got like, nothing. No,
it just sounded like
professional.
Yes, Dr. Drew. Okay, see what happens when you
and you didn't dispatch
back
with her the way I wanted to.
Wow. Yeah,
you were criticizing us for not dispatching with the bogus calls.
That was a bogus call, and Drew
smelled it out.
Didn't smell it until about 10 seconds.
Now
later.
Here's where we need to go to the next call.
No,
right
here's
now
we need to go to the we need to go to the
house. I just got here. What's going on?
We're going to the bathroom.
Get another Snickers bar.
You know what I want you to do when you go to the bathroom? I want you to take a good long look in the mirror. A good long look in the mirror.
Shut your pile.
All right, we'll be back. Hey, everybody, it's the Love Line. I'm Adam, that's Dr. Drew.
And I'm David Allen Greer, here to heal some babies. Let's take all your water.
That's my main man, David Allen Greer, from Life with Bonnie. Friday nights.
Are lap dances still legal in L.A.?
I don't know if there's they got that 6 foot.
No. They made a deal. So that they, because they were going to take it to a referendum, my strip club gods, and they've kept it real. Dr. Drew, you ever go to the strip clubs, do you?
No.
Does your honey bunny at home ever give you a little strippers thing there?
No.
She doesn't?
No.
I'll tell you something about Drew, as I told you off the air. Mm-hmm. He doesn't go to the strip clubs not because he doesn't like the ladies. It's because he likes the ladies too much.
Wow.
He's a man of such exquisite passion that he doesn't think he could hold his passion in while
dancing. So he's the one that when they bring up the house lights, he's going, hey, why'd you stop dancing? Hey, Destiny, why'd you stop dancing?
Yeah.
No, why'd you stop dancing?
Yeah.
I want my lap dance now!
Yeah, yes. He's a passionate man, and it's a switch. And once that switch is turned on, it needs to be seen through to fruition. Yes,
really?
True. Yeah.
Really?
There'll be no limping back to the hotel room and beating himself off. No.
Wow.
He finishes in the club.
Ooh.
That's that. Yeah, he finishes in the club.
Oh boy, that's
exciting. That's his policy. So he, he knows if he opens, he's like a junkie. Once he steps across that threshold, once he smells that sweet powdery perfume and hears those little 4 ounce bottles of champagne popping, it's game.
It always ends with yeah. I want my lap. Don't look at me. Don't look at me. Yes.
It's last call. We got to leave the club.
Yeah, thanks, dude.
I was at a strip club with Dag in Vegas once, and his stripper told... What did your stripper tell you? What did she confide in?
She'd been stabbed 17 times. I swear to you, she was stabbed 17 times. She was a Playboy centerfold circa 1979, and she had twin 13-year-old girls.
Yeah.
Good time.
Yeah.
Everyone else was having fun, and I'm just sitting there like, please get off of me. And her boobies felt like elbows.
Elbows?
They were hard and just bang, bang, bang.
That was
horrifying.
That was me.
Oh.
That was me.
Oh, my God.
You should have never closed your eyes.
Everyone else. And Adam told me, don't go in the champagne room. They went in there and they mugged me.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah.
Her yeah, you,
friend.
True.
They gave me a booby
what
beating.
Is that? What is
That's
that
the
mean?
Other thing you couldn't do.
What does that mean?
I don't go into those private rooms because you don't get out of there for under $1,500, $2,000.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. And it's one of those rack-up things you don't even know about. Right. It's like, who wants some Jaeger shots? Anyone want a Jaeger shot?
Or the songs. The songs go, that's the way, boogie, 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 boog I'm like, whoa, whoa, wait a minute. That's like four songs in 3 seconds.
Yeah. Yeah, it's really the music plays about as long as it plays when they're during the Grammys. Right. When they're showing the person that composed
the thing. During the Academy Awards, when people are walking down to get their award.
Then there's those special nights. There's those special nights. This really helped. This happened when I was in Palm Beach, and we went in the champagne room. I was feeling a little randy. So I did a show. I took one of the guys from the club. I said, look, it's on me. You know, I didn't want to go by myself. I said, you know, we're rolling out. So we went to some strip club. They put us in, like, the champagne room, which, by the way, was like a basement rec room of your best friend Scotty's. Okay? Because they had
Wayne's World.
Yeah, big farted out barca lounger.
Bumper pool.
Yeah. But it was broken. Everything was painted black and was peeling off. And all the strippers would pop. They would file through this room to go to the office or this one private bathroom or something. Anyway, the door was like, kablam, kablam! And it was opening and closing. And so we're in there, and these chicks, we're with these chicks, you know. And finally, this new chick comes in, and she starts giving me a lap dance. And so she's, like, working me out. And then all of a sudden, I said, you have to stop. She goes, why? I said, stop. Why? I said, why? And she goes, I said, why? And I went, because I hate you. That's all I had to say.
Really?
She said, what? Nobody ever said that to me. I'm like, you have to stop. Here's your money. Get off me. I can't do this anymore. I'm having feelings. And that was it. We spent the week together.
Really? Yeah. Wow. Good angle. What? Good angle.
Because nobody ever said, stop. I hate you. Get off me.
Right.
From then on, oh, man, it was great.
See, this is my theory. You got to call a fat woman beautiful. You got to call a thin woman smart.
There you go.
You see what I'm saying? You got
to
give them some.
You got to know when to hold them.
That's right.
Know when to fold them.
Speaking of singing,
know when
Dad,
to heal some babies.
Right. We're gonna play some. Then we're gonna play some Germany or Florida, and we're gonna need a new theme song. So, but don't do it yet. Not yet. Not yet, Dave.
Okay.
Not yet.
Dave, you're scaring me tonight,
Karen. No, he's fine.
I am.
He's fine. Karen.
Hey, boys.
Get some for
me
too.
What's
You're 24.
I'm 24, and you guys need to come to Sacramento, man. I own my own stripping company. What are you doing in Vegas?
Let me tell you something. Sacramento is banging. It has some beautiful women, but your strip clubs, you need to get you some VIP rooms.
No, we don't have a club. We have a private adult entertainment business. We come to you.
How does that work?
We do bachelor parties, bachelorette parties, divorce parties, that kind of thing.
Yeah, divorce parties.
And what is it?
I feel like some sort of like naive child tonight.
Is it an unspoken thing that a guy could get a little hand action or something like that for a few $100?
I mean, you can go to Nevada for that. That's illegal in California. No.
The answer is yes.
I then. you got to have a couple of gals on the roster who could really help out a BC celebrity like Dag over here if we waved around just a couple of Benjamins. Yes?
Well, if they do that, that's on their head. We don't talk about it.
First of all, my real name's Denise. It's not Lexus. And I've never done this before.
What I don't know, don't kill me, right?
All right. So what's up there, Karen?
Okay. I have a question. I'm an overweight girl. I'm 260. I'm really cute, though. I have a great personality, blah, blah, blah. Toot my own horn.
Listen, you better not be a bitch if you're 260.
No, not at all. Cool. Do I sound like a bitch?
No, you sound great. I'm just saying, you can't be mean at 260.
No. I know how to throw my weight around, though, if I need to.
All right.
I bounce. Come on now.
All right, Bumble. What's up?
I have this guy, we're not dating or anything, but every time that we have sex, he, like, tells me how hot my roommate is. Now, my roommate is a dancer for the company. She's a co-owner, too. So he bounces for her sometime. We'll be sitting here having sex, and he's like, oh, Kara's so hot. I'm like, well, what the hell? You want me to put a paper bag over my head and stick a picture of her on it? What?
Trouble.
So I'm wondering if a guy is a hole-to-hole. Like, they don't care.
No.
Well,
they care. Yes.
Yeah, we care. Otherwise, the same premium would be on Claudia Schiffer as it is on Margaret Cho. You see what I'm saying?
But do you know what I mean? Like, that's what he makes me feel like. Like, oh, hole, whatever.
Yeah, but you need to tell him that.
He's a bad guy.
Yeah, and there's... He's not a great guy.
By the way, I'd like to see how this business is run. You working out of an apartment with your stripper roommate?
No, we have
all right,
a
let
house.
Me do it. Let's do a little role playing. What's your name?
My name is Karen.
Oh, okay. Ring, ring, ring. Hello. May I speak to Karen, please?
Thank you for calling Paradise Productions. How can
My name's Dion, and look here. My woman left me, and I'm feeling bad. I want to feel better. Can I get about two or three honeys over here?
Two or three?
Yeah, two or three.
Do you want a toy show, or do you want just a girl on girl, or girl on girl with toys?
Here's what I like to do. I like to do a girl on girl. Put the toys on deck, right?
Okay.
You got anything else you can offer me besides just the toys and a girl on girl?
No.
Speak up, please. All right, no, I'm just saying, do you have anything else? Do you have any special talented girls, with special talents, anything they can do?
They do play games for you. They do the Tootsie Pop game or the banana game.
How's that go, the banana game?
Banana game is where you, this gets pretty crude. You stick a banana in.
Watch it.
Inside, and you peel it down, and then you tell the guy to suck your dick. And then they have to go down on the banana when it's inside. Suck.
And there's only one thing you say after a woman does that to you, Adam. Will you marry me?
You know what is so funny about it, though, is that guys will do it in front of all their friends. And the guys are like, oh, dude, we're telling everybody. Oh, I don't care.
Some guys
will do anything when they're drunk.
Yeah.
Really?
Yes, they will.
They'll take a Tootsie Pop. You know, she does the Tootsie Pop thing, and so whatever. They'll all lick off of it.
Yeah, now that...
I've seen that. I was in a bar when I was, like, 19. These guys lined up in a line, cheering each other on, and one after another, went down on this chick.
Yeah. I've seen the...
It was crazy. It was like an initiation
or
something.
I really feel like I've landed on Mars.
Tonight. No, this is when I was 19 in New York City. It was like, guys were like steel workers from Jersey. From Jersey, they lined up. I'm sitting there at the bar, and they lined up like they're cheering each other on, like high-fiving, like it was like a fraternity.
Yeah, they will. Oh,
absolutely.
That.
Yeah.
Or whipped cream up the butt. They'll all look it out.
Well, who hasn't done that?
Wait a minute.
Oh, boy. Cut off the next caller.
All right. So, listen, you're a big gal. You got a guy who's banging you.
He's an idiot.
He's talking about your roommate.
Yeah.
Maybe this ain't the guy for you.
Well, no, and I know that. And the thing that really bothers me, though, is that I've only had three sexual partners because I'm so picky.
How about the losing the weight thing? We just had a friend. Remember, Kathy's friend had the gastric bypass. She was in that weight, and she's now like 130.
And you know what? It's actually really funny. Is my mom is the Northern California representative for bypass. She was on 2020 and everything.
Yeah.
And she pressures me so much to get it. I think it would be doing it for her, not for me.
Yeah, was your mom overweight too?
Oh, my mom was like 430, and now she weighs 108, and she wears size 6. And
wow, it really is amazing. Some people, that is your genetic hand. You inherited from your mom. But some people need a medical intervention to correct
that. And listen, all you retards, and this is one of those chick things. It's a chick and gay thing where they go, I wasn't going to do it until I was going to do it for me. Other people wanted me to do it, friends 260? And loved ones. I wasn't going to do it. When it was time to do it for myself, then that's what the hell are you?
When Adam told Adam to do it for
shut
Adam,
up and go do it. If your mom tells you to do it, then do it. Your mom used to weigh as much as a RV. Now she's affable.
She goes, she only had three sexual partners because she's picky. No,
it's because
it's 260 pounds.
What she's picking amongst.
Exactly.
She should be.
Yeah. Super skinny black guys. That's the only guys who have sex with you. No black guys with no ass. What is that? It's always funny.
Let me talk to my lady. Candy!
It's always great when
my milkshake goes ding 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 ding. My milkshake ding 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 ding.
It's always great when the black guy's got a build like Tommy Hearns did when he was 19. You know, just all elbows, knees, no ass, 6'3".
I was like, what did he show up at the white girl store at the right before closing time? We only got two models left, Trixie and Candy, and they're both big ones.
Let's play Germany or Florida.
All right. Let's play.
Okay,
I got.
Look, I'm gonna give you a couple.
Here we go.
You want one?
Yeah.
All right. Cool.
Here we go.
Badum, atum, badum, zoom, da, 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 da. Is it Germany or Florida? Hey. Germany or Florida? Let's find out. Dun dun ba-doom, dun dun ba-doom, dun dun. Rock out!
Wow!
Oh, that was kind of cool.
Tori Amos didn't put that kind of effort near it.
Tori Amos. I kind of liked her, but
she's okay.
She's no Laura Nero.
No, and she ain't no dag, I'll tell you that right now.
The fairy talk is getting kind of tired, and she's a little older, but she still comes with it like, yeah, spirits anywhere.
I don't know if we can ever use that one, though, because it takes like an entire segment almost.
Oh.
Stop.
You
stop.
See? You see
we'll
that?
Talk over it. Don't worry.
Who is... Journey I swear, I'm gonna kill him. Florida.
All right, let me do another one.
All right.
It's in Germany. Oh, Florida. Germany. Oh, Florida.
That's the one. Yeah, that's it right on. There.
That's the keeper. That's the keeper.
Yeah. I broke the sweat, Dr. Drew.
All right, go ahead, Gavin.
Hey, guys, what's up?
What's up, man?
What's up?
Germany.
Drew,
Germany.
You are Germany. A passionate man.
Mm-hmm. True.
And, Dag, you are by all, like, the all-time greatest Loveline guest of all time.
True.
Yes, thank you.
And,
thank you so much.
Adam, you don't hear enough. You're a genius.
Wow. Thank you. Now
anyways,
go ahead.
A 24-year-old construction worker tied himself to a piece of scaffolding for safety while working on the fourth floor of the county jail annex. Forgetting he was attached to the metal, he tossed it to the ground and was carried along for the ride. He landed on the scaffolding, which pierced both his legs. He was treated for his injuries at a medical center nearby and hopefully counseled on the use of his most important safety tool, his brain.
Mm-hmm.
Florida. What exactly happened?
Feels like Florida to me. Construction accident. That in Germany, they're more precise. They're smarter. They're better engineers. Feels like Florida.
They don't have construction workers. They have machines do that.
I say Florida.
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 Drew?
Florida.
Florida.
Yeah, it's Florida. You guys are right.
That's how you play Germany or Florida, everybody.
Yes, sir.
Batting average, Drew?
Is it Germany or Florida?
It's like Ethel Merman. We're about 950.
Yeah.
Batting average.
All right.
Hey, what's she doing over there?
Let's help the babies. I don't know.
She's doing a radio show for the Virgin Islands.
Really?
Oh, there's somebody in the studio.
Let's heal some babies!
All right. Sarah?
Yes?
What's
going
on, Sarah? What's going on, baby?
About a month ago, I was with my boyfriend, and he was digitally penetrating me.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, it started to hurt.
Hold on a second. That's finger blasting. You didn't know. The digital
digitally? Why digitally?
Digital penetration.
Why
as opposed to analog.
Digital
is a more modern way of doing it.
That is so gay.
That's
man,
what you used to call finger
blasting. He was digitally penetrating me.
All right, whatever.
All right, go ahead,
I'm sick of her already.
Well, no, I think you'll find there's a reason she's talking
about
that. Yeah,
okay. Come on. Uh-oh. Let's get with it.
Anyways, it started to hurt, so I asked him to stop. And so he stopped, and then I fainted.
You fainted.
Le petit mot. It's called the little death. Right, mm-hmm. Dr. Drew?
Le petit mot. Yeah.
Petit mot.
All right. That's now, Drew, go ahead and ask your questions.
Yeah.
You got that baby voice.
It's the fact that you put so much drama into this experience suggests that it's traumatizing to you.
Or that he was wearing a Super Bowl ring.
Whatever.
But isn't this a phenomenon? The little death. Some women faint
they
when
do,
they...
But not...
Did you have an orgasm and then faint or what?
No.
You didn't.
This is really more dissociation, I suspect. Mm-hmm. Were you sexually abused growing up?
Not that I know.
No, not that I
were
know.
Were you physically
I'm
abused?
I'm sorry, I thought you were talking to me.
You
I'm
too.
I'm sorry. Not that I... Not
no.
That I know. No.
So why... Have you ever had sex before?
No, I have not.
No, I have not.
Was this the first time a guy's ever done anything like this to you?
No.
No.
Was it anxiety? Were you anxious when this was happening?
I might have been, but usually with him, I'm just really comfortable.
Yeah. But why do you think you fainted? Were you hyperventilating?
No.
Well, were you dehydrated? Had you done drugs? Were you overworked? What happened that day?
Nothing. We were just laying around.
Well, it's a vasovagal reaction when their heart slows and they react.
I know. I'm a doctor.
It's like swooning. And the fact that she describes it in these, you know, sort of weird terms, digitally penetrating me, as though it was some sort of military maneuver.
When she came to, he was cornholing, though.
Yeah, of course.
Stepped it up a little bit.
Is that true?
To be fair,
is that digital or analog, Mr.
No, to be fair to
that's
him.
That's analog.
To be fair.
Oh, no! Stop the tape! Dr. Drew is dropping some jokes in here. That's analog.
Let's give
a Def Jam welcome to Dr. Drew! Yo, dog, what were you doing to her? What were you doing to her, Drew, dog? What'd you say? Tell the people what you was doing.
Analog.
Oh, snap!
No,
Oh, snap!
See how much better time the blacks have than us,
Drew. Oh, that's beautiful. Well, look, I don't know what's going on with Honey Dip.
Yeah, sir, why is it so much energy? Why are you so anxious? Why... Why all this drama around this?
I don't know. It's just...
All right.
She doesn't know, and we don't care. So let's keep moving. Okay. You know when she came to, he was cornholing, though. Okay. And he's like,
line five.
He's like, oh, baby, I thought you died.
I'm trying to revive you with my Jimmy.
Michael?
Yeah?
You're 23?
Hey.
Something for Dak. That's a little payback from the belching and farting earlier.
Most of it got on Dr. Drew. Keep talking, man. Yeah. Keep talking. We're going to work through this.
That's nice.
And then when Adam,
get the funk.
Yeah, when Adam got the funk on, you got
to
watch
it. No, that's nothing.
It's bad.
That wasn't anything.
All right, I'll beat you, my friend, and I'll raise it up a notch.
No, I know you will. No,
one foot up.
I don't want to start that.
I'm Irishing out.
I'll defend you, bro.
All right, what's going on, man?
Hey, what's up, guys? Adam, Drew, David, love everything you guys do. Love Line, think you guys help a lot of people out. That's great. Listen to your show a long time, finally need your advice. I got an old friend I just started talking to again recently. Used to be really close to her, and she just now told me today that for the past couple of weeks she's been doing some smoking crack cocaine pretty heavy. And she knows I used to do it. I got off of it clean and without any rehab or anything. And it seems to me like she's calling me, trying to ask me for help. You know, I just want to know, how can I help her out? What can I say to her without sounding condescending, without sounding like I'm preaching to her? How can I get her some help? How can I let her know, you know?
You take her to treatment. You take her somewhere where they can help her. You can't do anything with this. The crack cocaine is a potentially deadly addiction, and you shouldn't be screwing around with it. You just take her to somebody who can
treat
her.
Hold on, David's black. David, what about crack cocaine? How does it work?
I don't know. I've never done crack.
Really?
No,
I've
never
really?
Done
crack. Wow.
No, my very racist friend, I haven't. But the problem is, I got a question.
Yeah.
Dude, are you involved with this chick, or is she just a friend?
I used to be involved with her, and I haven't spoken to her for a long time, but she just recently started calling me since she's started doing this, so that's...
All right, well, she's asking you for help, so
take her to help. You can start with a CA meeting. Just take her to CA meeting, meet with people who know where the good treatment resources
cocaine
in your community.
Hey, Drew,
save her life.
Nobody just sort of, it's not a phase, smoking crack.
No.
I mean, you don't get into it for a few weeks and then
it can wax and wane. You can get worse and get better and get worse and get better spontaneously, but it progresses.
Has the usage gone down, though?
I see a lot of it.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean... Did it peak and all that kind of stuff?
Yeah. It's,
well, it went down when Bobby and Whitney left the country, went to Israel for a couple of weeks. It dropped. It almost bottomed out for a few weeks there.
Speaking of another story in the press that's being misrepresented.
Oh, they're great. No.
The guy smacks her around, and then it's like, well, we just love. We have aggressive love. We fight for our love.
Well, who doesn't understand that, Dr. Drew? What's your point?
Wow.
What is your point?
True. He's a passionate man, certainly.
But does crack and cause like schizophrenia or like
psychosis?
Yeah, where you see like those guys.
Tom has a great description of his psychosis. But first of all, the first thing that every single smoking cocaine user gets is a preoccupation with uniformed officers outside of the building where they are. They believe they're out there.
But then, I mean, like, when you see them from afar.
Then they start freaking out about their body and picking at things. Right. Tom actually was pulling the conjunctiva off his eye and was trying to cut it.
What's the conjunctive?
The lining of your eyeball. He was pulling the white part, pulling it off, trying to cut it. Thought it shouldn't be there.
Yeah. He scraped all the sense of humor out of his brain.
Hey, look out. Adam C. That's Adam Krakatoli. He's going to be here at the Bunghole all the way through Sunday night.
And Drew, what about, and I don't know if you've been following Bobby and Whitney, but they were like back in Israel being dipped in the Jordan River because they were black Muslim and they were
Jewishites
or something.
Yeah, Jewishites. It wasn't like black. It's not the nation of Israel. Islam is the county. It's like, is that the same thing? Kind of similar, but not really.
Yeah, they're like a Nebru or something.
Nebru.
Yeah, I don't know what they were, but how come everyone just follows them? It's like, look what she's doing now. Isn't that great? And they're talking about spirituality.
Hey, the reviewer's got to go, hey, come on.
No one ever does.
God bless them. You know, I've hung out with Bobby and Whitney.
Have you?
Yeah, they always seem to be madly in love and great kids.
Well, let me say this.
They
Let me say something.
I'm not, I'm not kidding.
They have to be to put up with this.
I'm not kidding.
They're
I'm
what's
not
called
kidding.
Enmeshed. They're in a chaotic and meshed.
Well, you know, I look at them and I long for a relationship like that.
Yeah. That's the kind you would get into too. By the way,
a little worse than that.
Yeah, the one you were in.
Yeah. That's a disaster.
I think she's picking at her little coke booger zits and stuff.
The old girlfriend.
Yeah. I haven't seen her. I've moved on.
That's right. He's moving.
I'm breaking bigger halts. Let's save some babies.
All right. Let's move forward. And let me just say this before we move on. Bobby's had a run-in with the law. Anyone can mess up one time.
Right.
Let's turn the other cheek.
You're so
forward.
Jaded, Dr. Drew.
What are you talking
about?
Right,
we'll take a quick break.
Don't you get it? You're not getting it. He's not getting it.
He doesn't
I'm not
get it.
Getting it. No.
It's a black thing.
He's not getting
David
it.
David Alan Greer. I know Miss Dag and also my main man.
Daggeroni, if you're nasty. Hey, ladies, if you're out there, call in. I want to hear about your problems, your life, your hopes, your dreams. Daggeroni, all up in it.
Daggeroni, San Francisco Treats here tonight. We'll be right back.
Locky, shaka, daka, lock, let's save some babies.
Drew, quiet down. It's show starting now. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. David Alan Greer. You know him as Dag. I know him as my main man.
I have a question for Dr. Drew.
Yes.
Dr. Drew, what is normal sex? Isn't it what two adults agree to do to each other? Because I'm asking this because a lot of times, you know, when you're like anybody who deviates from the missionary position, you're like, oh, you have a serious problem.
No, I don't. No.
You have a very serious problem.
I think words like normal miss the point.
Really?
I think there's healthy things.
Healthy
is being able to sort of be present in reality and not have a lot of distortions and stuff coming
right,
there.
Right.
Well, you don't need to do things because you're acting
well, addressing
out,
like, definitely. See, well, Kathy Griffin says, you know, no girl would ever, like, want anal sex. Well, there's some girls
that do.
Exactly,
really like
that insist on
in
it.
In fact, like, have multiple orgasms.
Exactly. I've been with those girls. It's quite exciting.
Multiple penises in the rectum as well.
That's
done that.
Yeah, you don't want to be a part of that.
We've
Dag
and I have done that.
Hey, how you doing? Oh, is that Adam? Hey, man, how you doing? Scoot down. That's my bunion.
You've been moisturizing?
No, but you know what I'm saying? I mean, it's like, I don't, you know, those are, sometimes you run into those chicks.
That's
you
fine.
Know.
Oh, it's all good.
I wish we were on TV because your physical body language is like, you know, you're so sick, I won't even entertain your sickness.
No, it's
now, what I'm getting from
that,
you is,
that,
you know,
I'm scared of you.
Right, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Let's just, you know what, Adam, let's heal some babies. Come
all right, you ready?
I just am so...
Are you okay?
You know,
are you
well,
right?
I put myself out there
I know,
for
you
your
hung it
crack book, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And I think he was talking about himself there, some of those
I think
wackos.
It was, too.
And why all the broads? Huh? Always the cute girl.
Because the whole... The whole
mm-hmm.
thing was an exploration of boundaries, a metaphor for
exactly.
boundaries
right.
and what people need
boring.
To do.
Boring.
Yeah.
All right, you ready to move forward here, Dag? You okay?
Yes, sir.
All right, I'm sorry.
Reedy Bobolinkles.
Sorry that happened. Tyler?
Yeah, hey, how's it going?
You're 18. What's up?
Well, I just have this bad history of just dating a lot of crazy girls.
Mm-hmm.
Like, every single girl I've ever dated is just, like, completely crazy. At first, they seem normal. Then I find out later in a relationship, they're just, like, completely insane.
Yeah, welcome to Dag's world.
It's so laughable.
We have DNA for the crazy girls.
Mm-hmm. All right, you're 18. This is what happened.
What's your question?
Well, it's just, how can I get out of that? It's because...
Therapy.
I can't even tell because it seems like they're normal, you know?
Right, you're attracted to
that. All right, what are five big red lights that should be going off, like, on the first date?
If you ever hear this phrase repeatedly, you believe me, don't you?
No. Yeah.
That's one. You go. Yeah,
that's a good one.
Pass it down.
Here's one. Here's
how do you feel about your dad?
How do you feel about your dad?
Yeah.
A number one. B number two, the stories that are like everyone is out to get him kind of thing.
No.
Absolutely.
Everything happened because of what's out there.
I had a roommate who just screwed, she totally screwed me over. Yes. She
took you can distill that. You can distill that to this. They were jealous of me.
Yeah.
That's always like, why did you get a black guy? Because everybody at work was so jealous because I'm so beautiful. They were jealous of me.
They start, here's what it is. They'll start talking to you. And first you're going, wow, man, that's horrible
awful.
That
yeah,
a roommate.
Yeah.
And for no reason would just attack you this way. And I don't know. And it's like, why would somebody? And then it starts bleeding into work that the boss has it in for her. The other people are jealous because she's. And before you know it, everybody
he kissed me.
Yeah. Oh well, change that to changed that to went down on, and you get that.
No, but I'm like, has that ever happened? Has, right. ever, has a girl ever kissed you, and you're like, I was paralyzed. She just, doctor just started kissing me. I had to kiss her back.
Had to stick my tongue in her mouth.
Exactly.
What are you going to do?
Yeah,
so how do you feel about your dad? Some past relationships, too. If they had a string of real bad short ones, that's a bad scene.
And by the way, and most you notice when people have are aware that they're a little crazy, they'll answer very choppy, disconnected stories.
Yes.
They'll say, well, I can't really talk about that right now, but it was fine. It's a little, but anyway, so, they'll sort of distract and send you on other directions.
Yeah. And here's
how Gag's 10 questions.
Here's how you know they're completely effed up is the ones that don't make sense. Like the one that here's the story. It's like, I got fired from my job. Why? I don't know why. I do the work of 5 employees. I'm never late. I never steal. Yeah. All I do is create. And I get S-canned. It's like, and you think to yourself, now you do the math. Why would you fire an employee that was never late and did the work of 5 other employees? And then they go, and you go, why? And they go, and they had it in for me. And then you realize, all right, that's it.
Wacko. I went out with a girl once, and I bring her to my house, and I'm like, asking her my 10 questions, and one of them's like, have you ever been committed? Like, everything was like, do you have a...
Do you take medicine?
Are you currently under the care of a psychiatrist? Are you taking any psychotropic drugs, whatever? I go, have you ever been committed? She goes, now see, I you know what happened? My friends, I was like, to the door!
Well, first
some love.
Yeah.
First some rough trade love.
Wow.
What did that sound like?
I had to know!
What did that sound like?
Look, baby, I know you're crazy. I know you. Don't look at me! Don't look at me! Turn your head! Yeah. You like this.
That's how it always ends.
Dave, I want to get some Sunny D out of the fridge, and you're on my arm.
Oh, still, don't pull away from me. Don't make me chase you. Come here. Ah.
All right, okay.
Love making in Dag's house.
Yeah. I'm getting into this Japanese rope bondage.
It's beautiful. Yeah, it's great.
It's beautiful knot.
Dag's spiraling out of control with some weird fetish.
Hey, Dr. Drew, I can't get this granny knot untied. This chick's turning blue.
It's called a spunk shway.
It's true.
No, I hate you. I hate you.
Alyssa. Yeah. You're 23. We got another Germany or Florida coming up there.
Uh-oh, bring it on, baby.
All right, Lisa, what's going on?
I'm not doing the German Florida thing, okay?
Yeah, good.
Yes, you are.
I just want to say that David Allen Gray, if they're possibly the biggest fan in the whole entire world, it could be
me.
Thank you, baby.
You're 23.
Where do you live?
I live in Oaktown, California.
Are you from there?
Born and raised. All right, when we get off the air, you got to give Adam your phone number. I'll be contacting you shortly. I'm having a fan weekend.
Can I tell you that I know things by heart?
Hold on. Let me explain fan weekend. He beats off while
blow
somebody
it,
fans
don't blow it!
It.
Adam, please.
Describe yourself.
She's 23. She's a law student.
What up?
Yeah. What do you look like?
Hey, I'm Tom, 6'1".
Ooh.
Bring it on.
Mm-hmm.
What else do you want to know?
Can you elaborate?
You mentioned the weight.
I'm
that's
tall
bad.
And 6'1", too.
Wait, you think that's bad?
What's your weight?
I'm just saying.
No,
do you have long hair, short hair?
I have long
hair. Be at least 150 at 6'1".
Long
Why would you preoccupy yourself with weight?
This young woman is
happy because she likes me. Is that what you're saying?
No, I'm saying at 6'1", you got to factor in how
I love her already. She's a wonderful, spunky, bright girl. How much you weigh, baby?
David Andre, can I give you a quick snippet and you tell me if you said it or not?
All right, go, baby, go.
Okay. I'm running a marathon.
Yes.
It's 5th mile. Everything's cool. I'm feeling strong. I'm feeling good.
Yes.
10th
yes.
mile, society starts to break down. 15th
yes.
mile,
that's
I'm
true.
Jumping into trees, eating fruit.
That's, right. That's
while
true.
Walking.
That's true. She knows my whole thing. Let's get back to the weight. How much? You carrying a caboose
Irvine Improv?
Huh?
Okay.
Yeah, are you carrying a caboose back there? Talk to me, baby.
Hey,
what's your
I'm from Oakland. LA face.
What's that,
man? Booty, don't talk.
Uh-oh. Mm-hmm. How big is it? How big is it? Let me know. Just let me know. How big is it?
Do you want my number? Because I'll bring it.
Well, hold on. We need to talk about the booty first. How big is the booty? Let me know. You're loved here.
Okay.
Let's talk in honesty.
Well, let's see.
All right. You're 6'1".
No, you're 6'1". How many?
Hang on, I believe she called with a problem.
No, we're getting to the problem.
Yeah, you're big, you sure are.
Alicia's a big gal.
You a big gal, Alicia?
Alisa?
Alisa, what's going on?
Uh-oh.
Alisa, what's going on?
Alisa? Wait, hold up, Alisa. All right, go ahead. What's your problem?
I have to be honest. I just love David Allen Greer. I just like.
Come on, just tell me how much you weigh. You are loved here. This is a safe place. Safe place.
No, I'm not gonna even waste your guys' time with all that.
Go ahead,
stuff.
Go ahead. Tell me.
All right, this is big gal. 200. Big gal.
Yeah, you think so?
I don't know. I have no idea.
I told you.
When?
Oh my God. This isn't even actually on the air, is it, right?
No, we're not on the air.
No, we're at Dave's house.
How much do you weigh? How much do you weigh, baby?
I weigh 160.
Huh? Uh-oh. No, that's worked. 6'1". That's 6'1".
Yeah.
Man, get her number, man.
All right. We'll get your number off the air for Dag.
I'm always coming up north.
She's 23. She may be coming out this
and
way.
And she's a lawyer. She can represent herself in the case a problem developed.
Dag, you got the Fan Appreciation Weekend coming up.
I do.
Nothing wrong with that. Dag's he's a lonely man, by
I'm
the way.
I'm not lonely. My life is very fulfilled. I have dogs and...
Right. He's
got the Wayne's brothers and dogs.
He's going to vomit or cry. I'm not sure.
All right, Jeremy. Well, I want to save some babies. We have 20 minutes.
But, I mean, he's a lonely man, Drew.
Oh, jeez. I usually make it to the car before I bust out the old waterworks.
He was in a long-term relationship
I'm healthier now. I'm much healthier
and
now.
And it's just been basically banging Asian hookers for the last months.
Not Asian hookers.
Nothing. What do you like, Dag? You like a white woman? You like a black woman?
You know, a race serves no purpose. I mean, right. I really don't care what race they are. It's the inside. Mm-hmm. The sickness inside, as I call it.
That's
you know?
You're attracted to.
That sweet, sticky center. That's what I like.
You like the nougat.
Yeah, it's usually like a dead, flat voice, you know, and you go like, hi. And I go, wow. And then my heart jumps, you know, where I know there's some dysfunction there.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll put like, one time I was at a wedding, and I go, sit next to this girl. She's great. She's wonderful. And I'm like, are you addicted to anything? She said, no. Do you have any kind of dysfunction? She said, no, I really have no point in talking to you.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's save some people.
Yeah. Dag needs...
He tried
project.
To hate you, get away from me.
He needs
me.
A project, yeah, right. And that's the problem with that.
That's, I know, your, that's that your acid test line.
That worked like a charm, man. I was in every strip club, every time. I was like, I hate you, get away from me. Hey, whoa, she's
the guy was the bouncer was like, still $14 to get in.
I hate you, get away from me, Bruno.
It's 2-drink minimum.
Come on, man, let's take some calls.
All right, we got to take a break.
Man, wait a minute.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something about Dag. No one screams, let's save the babies, more than him.
Let's save the babies!
Meanwhile, we take a call and a half every hour.
Yeah, but
45.
You're slacking off. You have to be more disciplined.
He said slacking,
with containing
right?
him, yes.
Okay. We'll take a quick break. We'll be right back. Hey, everybody, it's the Love Line. I'm Adam. That's Dr. Drew, David Allen Greer, Dag, my main man in studio. You know what? I'm jealous of the blacks. I'll tell you why I'm jealous of the black man. Because Dag knows every black. They're all, it's one big family.
It's true.
You see what I'm saying?
It's true.
And they do kill each other quite a bit, but when they're not killing each other, it's one big family. Like, I was on an airplane sitting next to Tommy Davidson.
Oh, I heard
Tommy Davidson. Jim Brown, Hall of Fame running back, Jim Brown turns around and is like, hey, brother, hey, my man. They're hugging, they're high fives all around, they're leaning over me. They're Tommy, what's happening? It's like, really? You're a big fan of Tommy Davidson? Like,
and we all know each other, man.
That's what I'm saying. Is there
it's
the
all part of God's plan.
Yeah, you think Johnny Unitas comes up to me and says, oh, Adam, no, you didn't.
Adam, how are you?
think that happens?
No, you're
jealous.
No,
it's too
jealous.
Many of us.
You should be jealous.
I should be.
Dr. Drew, are you trying to train the next Drew?
Yeah, what about the next Drew?
What about him?
Well, do you have like a protege?
No, he's got Dr. Bruce.
Someone
Bruce.
You're trying to
Yeah,
Bruce and smart. Dr. Mike, too, when he was up here.
Yeah, Drew, but Drew gets people that are so horribly qualified to fill in for him that you couldn't possibly do
No,
it,
but I mean, you're so committed, you're addicted to saving addicts, which in and of itself is an addiction.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I won't even get into.
Mm-hmm.
But do you have like a young protege that you snatched out of med school?
I got medical students regularly now. And
All right.
We have a couple young guys we're trying
to
find
to play a little Germany or Florida, by the way.
Germany... Does everybody sing a theme song?
Well,
no.
Is it Germany or Florida? Germany or Florida?
That's pretty good.
Cassie, yeah, that was solid.
Yeah.
Go Hi, ahead, guys. Germany. What's happening?
Oh, well, first I want to tell you, me and my best friend love you guys so much, and she even made a paper mache shrine to you, Adam, in high school.
Thank you. I made one out of paper towels when I was in high school.
How old are you?
Your hamper. It was your hamper that stood up.
She's 19? Okay.
19. You just turned it upside down. It stood up in a
bunch. Yeah. Like
I'm good at this. Germany or Florida?
Go ahead.
Look at the little doggy.
Here we go. Come on, Dag. Focus. Right, okay. Here we go.
Okay, this happened in 1996. Right. A 21-year-old man is stalking Bjork. He plans to kill her by sending a book that will explode with sulfuric acid when it's opened.
Germany.
Mm-hmm. Feels
After
like Germany.
Sending the package, he paints his face red and green and shoots himself on camera to complete his video documentary. Germany. Nope.
Oh,
That is a sucker punch there, honey.
That happened in Florida?
Hollywood, Florida.
Oh. Wow.
That is so Germany.
German immigrant... Hans Schnetzelberg,
what was the guy's
vacationing
name?
In Hollywood, Florida.
It was on Prime Time tonight.
Oh, all right.
Oh, you cheater.
Well, good work, Cassie. Good. You beat
Thank
us.
You.
We're going to send you out to Windbreaker.
Okay.
All right, baby doll. Okay. Thanks you. Thank you very much.
Thanks
all right.
you.
Thanks
you. Do you snowboard?
No.
How's your honey bunny? How's your wifey?
She's good.
Does she have any solid friends for me?
She got a couple of solid friends, yeah.
Why do you look at me like that? I can hold
don't
myself
look at me.
Up. Don't look at me. Don't look. Turn your head. Turn your head. Don't come here. Don't run from me. Don't run from. Don't run from me. You better hold. Stick. Hold. Sell.
It never gets old.
It never gets old.
Because I'm hitting home. We've all done that, haven't we?
Dang,
right when you're like at the peak of, you know, manliosity, just yeah.
It's like the plug has been pulled. Adam usually asked for a sandwich and the remote control.
Yeah, but it's like this.
Sandwich.
It's like the little voice. The sandwich sits right near your mouth.
Eating and sleeping.
This smells like peanut butter. Oh my god.
Aubrey?
Yes.
You're 23?
Yes.
Good. What's up?
First, I want to ask a more wholesome question. I just wanted to know how Dr. Drew felt about holistic healing.
He doesn't like it.
No, I just think that putting things in your mouth to change your body is an outdated idea, that we need to be much more involved in the mental health and spiritual health of people.
So
and
let
that
me,
there will not be a magic pill or combination of pills that makes you somehow live life better and more fully. It's ridiculous. It's about exercise. It's about interpersonal relations.
So Paxil's your...
No, if you have an illness...
Well, someone said you put something in your mouth, it's not going to make you feel better.
If you're Maybe healthy.
I'm saying that if you're nuts... None of those medications are going to help because you put them in your mouth.
If you're healthy.
No further questions, Your Honor. Witness, please step down.
He just
put
his foot in his mouth.
There you go. Yeah, get it out.
Yeah. If you're healthy.
Get it out.
It's not putting things in your mouth aren't going to make you healthier. That's
the point. I'm not necessarily saying like medication or herbs or anything like that, but like acupuncture and
acupuncture is great.
Medicine.
But again, medicines, putting things in your system to be healthier when you're already healthy.
And let me just explain
a couple of quick things.
That's not what homeopathy is based
I'm just saying.
All that homeopathic crap is like
I think it's homeopathy.
You might as well just scrape some of the dust off old Chinaman's balls and eat it. You get about the same medicinal use out of it. It's true. It's all this is nonsense.
What
it's for screwballs.
What has happened to you?
Look. It's just nonsense. And let me tell you something about the herbal, you know, the Orient. Screw them. We're way ahead of them.
You disgust me.
Let's go back 2,000 years and see if we can heal ourselves.
When the life expectancy was 30 years.
Yeah, they invented gunpowder.
Yeah, they're geniuses. They're all geniuses over there. And
they invented the printing press.
Let me explain something.
Half of women can expect to die in childbirth.
Everybody thinks the rest of the world is better than us at everything else. Why do we kick their ass? Why do they all come here?
You cannot be serious.
It's
and
true.
You think this is a plot. They're trying to make this Beijing, man.
Mm-hmm. Aubrey, go ahead.
Okay, and my other question was about asphyxiation.
Yeah.
I just wanted to know, like, why that would be a turn-on for somebody. Like,
because it gives them a near-death experience, and in that state, when the oxygen supply and the blood supply to the brain is cut off, the brain is flooded with endorphins, and you feel a euphoria. And an orgasm and euphoria is sort of a very powerful combination.
Right. Yeah.
And people very often misjudge that and stroke out and they're dead.
Yeah. Very dangerous.
I dated a girl that had a book fetish. Right before she was about to climax, I'd hit her in the head with a book and it just dazed her.
Sidebar for a second, Adam.
Yeah.
Is it my imagination?
It was the Bible.
Or is Dave getting just more and more out there every time he comes in here?
Yeah, I think he's getting more comfortable with us, and so the truth is starting to come out.
Okay, good. I feel better.
He had a facade of before.
Make sure he's not progressing.
It's as if he's getting drunker each time he shows up, and more he's bearing more of a soul.
Okay, now, Jimmy.
We, by the way, all kidding aside, Drew and I lost a friend of ours who was...
Did you?
I was 25, 26 years old.
Doing this stuff.
Doing this.
Did you know that he... I'm way too lazy for that.
Had no idea what he was up to, but
you had
he
no
ain't
idea.
Here anymore.
Nobody
and, I mean, this guy was 25, 26.
It's real easy to hang yourself.
Mm. Yeah.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, Drew, don't people do it? And I don't know how our friend was doing it, but is it a plastic bag or something?
And or they have a whole procedure they go through. They sort of tie a thing up at a high height and lean against it with it around their neck.
But I heard a story about parents whose young son hung himself, and it was so quick, no sound. The father describes walking by his son's room. He was upset about his homework. They had no idea he was as upset, and he was sitting on the edge of his bed. He comes back, he's dead. Yeah. Like, somehow he'd rigged something, and he was sitting on his bed. He leaned forward, he hung himself.
But that's what don't people don't appreciate. You're talking about, it's not about not breathing. It's about interrupting the blood supply of the brain.
Yeah,
and then pow.
Once you pass out,
that's
then,
it. That's completely fine.
That's right. We all
and I'm crazy. That's funny. Yeah. Let's take another call.
That's interesting.
Now!
Somebody said he was crazy? I didn't say he was crazy.
No.
I heard it.
So we're going to take a break. We're going to go to the bathroom. Dave's going to take another good long look in the mirror. Long look in the mirror.
A good long look in the mirror.
We didn't hear cheer tonight either.
Well, you know, you're so busy diagnosing.
Yes.
Germany.
Yes.
Oh, Florida. It's Germany.
Oh, Florida. All right. We'll be back.
I'd like to say congratulations to Chris and Gwenny and the baby on your marriage.
Give him a cheer.
Yeah.
I'm not here as some performing seal.
Dance.
I gave you a knob. No, I will not.
Pick your nose.
I'm picking my nose.
We didn't heal as many babies as I usually do.
We didn't.
I love Mike. I love K-Rock. I love all you peoples.
All right. David Alan Greer for Crank Yankers and Life with Bonnie.
Beautiful.
Tuesday nights
beautiful.
On Crank Yankers Comedy Central and Friday nights, ABC, 9:30. Part of the TGI lineup. So... Until next time. TGIF, sorry.
TGIF.
All right, F you.
Thank God.
Until
Friday.
Next time, this is Adam Carolla for Dr. Drew saying
salami and bacon. Ow!
Mahalo.
Germany! Oh, Florida! It's Germany! Oh, Florida!
This has been Loveline. The opinions expressed on this show are not necessarily those of the staff, management, sponsors, or this station. The producer for Loveline is Ann Ingold. Loveline is a presentation of Westwood One Entertainment.